graphic audio. A movie in your mind.
Graphic Audio and Archie Comics present Vampironica by Greg and Meg Smallwood. Narrated by Nanette Savard and a full cast. Cheryl Blossom's house in Pembroke Estates was well known to the student body at the local high school and several others in the area. Whenever her parents were out of town, and they seemed to be out of town a lot, Cheryl would throw a party. The Blossom house had a lovely flagstone patio with plenty of room for tables, chairs, and kegs. The pool was heated, and there was comfy furniture inside the house in case anyone felt like passing out.
All right, everybody.
The hostess came through the wide-open sliding glass door, clad in a bikini top and shorts, and brandishing two liquor bottles.
Who's up for some body shots?
That invitation got the immediate attention of a couple of Pembroke athletes who were helping one of their teammates execute a keg stand.
Whoa! Ooh, yeah, I'll go.
Me first!
They left him on the ground and headed towards Cheryl.
Easy, boys. There's plenty for... Everyone?
Something moved in the shadows at the side of the house. A figure stepped into the dim glow from the strings of party lights. His face was ghastly pale, his eyes red. Something dark stained his mouth and the front of his shirt. His lips drew back, revealing unnaturally long, unnaturally pointed teeth that glistened with what looked like blood.
No!
Hey! Ugly!
The creature whipped around as a woman in black ran from the house and landed a solid right cross to his jaw. The creature didn't fall and seemed to be gathering himself for another attack.
We can do this the easy way, or we can do it the hard way.
The woman narrowly evaded his raking claws.
Fine.
She raked his neck with her claws and buried her knee in his groin.
We'll do it the hard way.
She grabbed the creature by the front of his gory shirt and pulled a thick wooden stake from her jacket pocket. But before she could deliver the killing blow, another red-eyed demon dashed from the shadows. At first, no one wanted to get close enough to the pool to see what was happening in its depths as the surface bubbled and roiled. As they crept closer, a massive red stain began to spread in the water, garish in the glow of the underwater lights. A sleek black head emerged from the red water and moved toward the shallow end of the pool, where Cheryl stood by the stairs.
Veronica Lodge?
Veronica stood up in the waist-deep water and pulled two dead vampires above the surface. Her eyes glowed red as she smiled, displaying perfect, pointed teeth.
Hey, Cheryl. Cool party.
2 days before Cheryl Blossom's pool party, Veronica was poised several feet off the ground, supported by her fellow Riverdale High School cheerleaders, shaking her pom-poms high in the air.
Break that ball! Make them fall! Across the goal line, take the ball!
With a small hop, she jackknifed her legs, pointed her toes, and landed lightly in the arms of Betty and Midge.
Go Bulldogs!
Back on her feet, Veronica continued to jump up and down with the rest of the squad, shaking her pom-poms and smiling brilliantly.
You make it look so easy, Ronnie.
Veronica turned toward Archie Andrews, still clad in his football gear and uniform. His teammate, Reggie Mantle, was right behind him.
Archiekins!
Veronica wrapped her arms around Archie, missing not only the surprised look on his face, but also the disgruntled glance from Betty.
So, where are you taking me for our date tonight?
Did we make plans?
Well, not yet. But I knew you just hadn't got around to asking.
To Veronica's dismay, Archie winced slightly.
I'm sorry, Ronnie. I've already got something going on with...
Betty Cooper grabbed Archie's arm, smiling triumphantly.
Betty.
I hope you don't mind me borrowing it for the night, Ron. It's just going to be a total chill night.
Popcorn, romantic comedies.
We can always swing by Pops to hang for a bit.
Veronica forced a fake smile that she hoped didn't look too snarly as she reached out, grabbed Reggie, and dragged him closer without even looking at him.
Don't be ridiculous. You two have fun. Reggie already asked me out anyway. Right, Reggie?
Yeah. You know it, babe.
Archie put one arm around a smiling Betty's shoulders as he waved goodbye with the other.
Okay, cool. Catch you guys later then.
Veronica allowed herself to pout as she watched them walk away. She forgot about Reggie until he put his arm around her waist.
Perfect timing, Ronnie. My parents are out of town all week.
She shrugged away from him.
Hey, what?
You want to go out? You can pick me up at 6. Daddy's having a client over, and I don't want to get stuck with them at dinner.
What about?
6 o'clock sharp, Reggie.
That evening, Veronica sat at her vanity in her bedroom, carefully putting the finishing touches on her lips. She glanced at her phone and the latest text from Reggie. It read, "Just passed Archie in his rust bucket on wheels," followed by a stuck-out tongue emoji. The previous text read, "Bringing the jag," and before that, "On my way, babe." Veronica gazed at a picture tucked into the frame of her vanity mirror. Archie had his arm around her as they grinned at the photographer. She kissed the tip of her finger and touched it to the chest of Archie's image. She didn't want to smear lipstick on his face. Reggie's latest text read, "Be there in a sec."
Okay, I'm coming.
She flipped off the vanity lights and walked to the bedroom door. Veronica was vaguely aware that the house was unusually dark, considering her parents were entertaining a guest.
Okay, Daddy, I'm going out. I'll be back in a little while, but don't wait up.
She reached the bottom of the stairs and paused in the darkened foyer.
Daddy?
It sounded as though something had fallen hard in her father's study. The doors were slightly ajar, and dim light streamed from the crack. After a moment, Veronica cautiously approached.
Daddy? Is that you?
She stopped in front of the doors and peered through the gap. The only light came from the lamp on the desk, but she saw nothing out of the ordinary. Nothing moved or made a sound. She grasped the doorknob. Hiram and Hermione Lodge lay face down on the Persian carpet, deathly still.
Daddy! Mother!
Veronica ran to her father and knelt beside him. He didn't respond. She carefully pulled on his shoulder until he rolled onto his back.
Oh, God. No. Daddy!
Hiram Lodge's skin was devoid of color, and his eyes were rolled back in his head. His immaculate shirt collar was stained red with blood that dribbled from 2 holes in his neck. Veronica was frozen with shock and grief until a shadow from behind her darkened her father's face. She slowly looked over her shoulder.
You must be Veronica.
A large hand closed over her throat and hauled her off the floor.
Don't worry, my dear.
His skin was thin and white and wrinkled, his eyes glowing red.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.